bottle in the garbage.
Don't you know plastic's going in the blue container?
Mayor Frank Jackson and the City of Cleveland are committed to keeping your neighborhood clean and green through the use of the city-issued trash and recycling carts. It's safe, convenient, and mandatory. For more information, contact the Cleveland Division of Waste Collection at 216-664-3717.
How did you get to be so smart?
I had a good teacher.
Senior co-ed volleyball game. My name is Yasmin Record, and with me is Ashley Jackson. Ashley, I'm pretty sure a lot of parents out there are trying to figure out how can they get their young people involved in the senior co-ed volleyball program. Can you tell us more about the program?
The program is for ages 15 to 18 if you're still in high school. It's a co-ed program. We have 16 travel teams, 158 girls and boys that participated in the program. The players and the instructors participated in training and fundamentals of volleyball prior to the season. Season opener is November 6th. You can go to any recreation center and sign your child up. Games played on Tuesday evenings, which bring us to our championship game today between the Corey Lightning Bolts and the Zone Raiders.
Well,
yes, what can you expect for the game?
Well, for the senior co-ed game, you can expect to see some spectacular volleyball. We really, again, have to commend these young men and women as they are great athletes on the courts and also scholars off the court. I mean, they're having fun and hitting the books at the same time. So, again, for the championship game, we have the Corey Lightning Bolts playing against the Michael Zone Raiders. Corey actually beat Earl B. Turner in the playoffs to advance to the championship game. And the Zone Raiders beat Thurgood Marshall. Both teams actually ended the regular season 5-0. So, again, this is going to be some competitive volleyball that we'll see today. So at this point, what I'm going to do, I'm going to pass it over to Edwin Santiago, who's going to go ahead and do the player introductions.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Glenville Rec Arena for the 2018 Senior Co-Ed Volleyball Championship featuring Corey Lightning Bolts and the Michael Zone Raiders. Introducing Corey Lightning Bolts, an 11th grader at Horizon, number one, Jessica Suber. A 10th grader at Laurel School, number three, Jada Allen. Number five, 9th grader at Maritime High School, Geneva Payne. 10th grader out of Benedictine, number seven, Isaac Harris. 10th grader out of St. Martin de Porres, number eight, Carlin McKenzie. 10th grader at Bard School, number 11, Stanley Martin. 12th grader at Invictus, number 15, Maurice Gray. Wearing number 16 from St. Martin de Porres, number 10th grader, Angel McAllister. Corey Lightning Bolts are coached by Ms. Victoria Thomas, Ms. Jessica Daniels, and Mr. John Griffey. For Michael Zone Raiders, 12th grader at Rhodes School, number three, Anna Sango. 11th grader at Rhodes, number four, Angel Perez. We're number 12, a 12th grader at John Marshall, Mohammed Roby. 9th grader at New Tech, number 13, Lydia Nahambaz. 10th grader out of Thomas Jefferson, number 17, Intisar Musa. 12th grader at Promise Academy, number 18, Alexander Ortiz Vargas. 12th grader at Thomas Jefferson, number 18, Francesca Leonardo. Zone Raiders are coached by Ms. Samantha Blaha and assisted by Ms. Alicia Connor. At this time, we ask that you rise and face the flag for the playing of our national anthem.
Ashley, let's go over the rules for today's volleyball game. For the game, we actually have what you call rally scoring. You don't have to be serving to score. The home team serves first. There has to be 6 players on the court, at least 3 girls at all times. You must win 2 out of 3 matches to win the game. The seniors play to 25 and must win by 2. Each team gets 2 timeouts per game, 6 per match. The ball must be rolled under the net when returning it to the opponent, and if not, then the first offense warning, you get an offensive warning, and then the second, there's actually an offense side out or a point.
Our substitutions. Instructors must signal officials. The coach must sub for the same position or player. Each team is permitted only 1 request for substitution during the same dead ball. Mandatory play. All kids must play one match. Boys can spike the ball when they are only in the back position. A legal block is not considered a hit. A double hit on the first play is legal. During the serve, if the ball comes in contact with the net and goes over the net, the serve is good and play will continue.
And when we talk about the keys to the game, when we talk about the Zone Raiders, let's talk about the referees because we need referees for this game. So our referees for today's game is?
We have our first official to the left, LaDonna Johnson, 33 years in recreation, 28 years in teaching in the CMSD, volleyball coach at East Tech in Glenville for 28 years, 2015 CMSD Volleyball Coach of the Year, 19-8 graduate of Glenville High School, and a graduate of Kent State. Her sport she played was volleyball, and she ran track, and her favorite sport is volleyball.
And our other official is Shantae Jackson. She's a 1996 graduate of Glenville High School. She's a 2015 graduate of CSU. She's a special ed teacher at Glenville High School. She has 15 years as supervisor of Rec Summer Lunch Program. She's the owner of Sustainable Body Fitness Personal Training. First year as a personal trainer. In her sports history, she coached teams that won 5 volleyball titles at Glenville. She coached the Sim Raiders youth program cheerleaders, and her favorite sports are basketball and volleyball. Ashley, let's talk about the keys to the games for both of these teams.
Well, Corey Lightning Bugs, their record was 5-0 this season. They beat Earl B. Turner 2 out of 3 matches, 25-22 and 25-21. They say they have to encourage each other, communicate in togetherness as a team.
And for the key games for the Zone Raiders, they're actually, again, 5-0, but their teams, the coach said they need to communicate on the floor. They need teamwork. The extra practices that the coach held, she definitely feels that it's going to pay off in this championship game.
For our key players to watch, we have Jada Allen, number 3. She's a team leader, dedicated, and works hard. Then we have number 8, Carolyn McKenzie. She's a 3-year player, will try out for a college squad. And then we have number 15, Maurice Gray, big brother on the team, most improved and strives for the best.
And our key players for Zone Raiders is Instasar Musa, a great dunker and hitter, very smart. Alexander, number 18, Ortiz, a great attacker and server and actually the team leader. And we finally have number 10, Ariana Brown, very solid server, aggressive player, and also a team leader. And here we go, folks, first serve of the game, and it's an ace. And our server is actually number 10, and that is Ariana Brown from Max Hayes. She's an 11th grader. Coach says she's a teacher, coach. She's on the merit roll, and in addition to volleyball, she loves basketball. So we have a side out.
Up right now we have Jada Allen, which is one of our key players. She is from Laurel, 10th grader. She wants to become a doctor, an OBGYN. Honor roll student, perfect attendance and citizenship. She's actually she loves volleyball and dancing. She's actually with our show wagon as well through the summer.
And another nice serve.
Oh.
And another point. And the score right now is Corey 3, Zone 1. Can Jada score another point? Nice serve, and that's an ace. Oh, Zone actually has to communicate. That's one of the keys to the game for Zone, is that the coach is saying, hey guys, open up your mouths, you have to communicate. Somebody has to call for the ball. There you go. And that's a lift, and we have a side out. And the score right now is Zone 2, Corey 4. And that's a beautiful serve by number 18, Alexander Ortiz Vargas. He attends Promise Academy. He's a 12th grader. He's on the merit roll, citizenship, outstanding volleyball player. Nice bump. Nice set. Nice spike.
Uh-oh.
Nice recovery. Oh, and that ball is out.
This is going to be a great game because these are our older co-ed team, which is 15 to 18. You're going to see a lot of bump, set, spike.
Nice serve. Nice recovery. Nice spike. And that's a point. And the score right now, Corey 5, Corey 6, Zone 2. And our server is number 15. Who's at number 16?
Angel McAllister.
Nice bump. Nice set.
Let's see if they can get a good setup.
Nice
good
play.
Spot.
Nice backhand set. Nice dunk. Oh, nice spot. Nice recovery. This is really a good rally by both teams. Ball goes into the net, and we have a side out.
We have Zone with 3 and Corey with 6.
And our server was number 4, Angel Perez, who knocked the ball into the net, and we have a side out.
Right now we have number 8, Carolyn McKenzie, one of our key players of the game.
Nice bump. Nice set.
Uh-oh.
Nice spike by number 18, Alexander Ortiz Vargas. Again, Alexander is one of the key players to watch. The coach said he's a great attacker, as you just saw. Look at this spike. I mean, he really is a very hard spike. And our server was number 12, Muhammad Roby, who just knocked the ball into the net, so we have a side out.
So up for the serve, we have Stanley Martin. He goes to Bard. He's in the 10th grade, 15-year-old. His career goal is a pro football player. Good dink from Gunny.
And we call that a lift, a legal hit. That's a point for Corey. And the score right now is Corey 9, zone 4.
Oh, nice serve. Nice power.
And we have a net ball inside out. And our next server for zone is number 3, Anna Sangle. She attends Rhodes. She's a 12th grader, and she just knocked the ball into the net. But Anna's also on the merit roll and has perfect attendance.
And we're up with Jessica Suber from Horizon Academy, 11th grader. Wants to join the Army as an infantry officer once she graduates. Look like we side out in his zone ball.
And our next server.
6-11.
Very good serve. And the score right now is zone 7, Corey 11. And the score right now, Corey's in the lead, 11, zone 7.
And this is Maurice Gray with the serve. He goes to Invictus, a 12th grader.
Nice spike. Nice recovery.
Good communication with Corey over here. So Maurice is up for his second serve of the game. Look at this bump set spike. She couldn't control it. Maurice is also a key player of the game. He's the big brother of the team. And he strives for the best, and he's the most improved.
And the score right now, Corey 14, zone is 7. Wow. Powerful server. And our next server is number 10. Ariana Brown. She attends Max Hayes. She's 11th grader. She's on the merit roll, and in addition to volleyball, she loves basketball. And she just put the ball into the net, and that's a side out. And right now, Corey's in a lead, 15, zone 8. And this is game 1 of the 2018 Senior Co-Ed Volleyball Championship. Nice serve. Oh, that was a carry.
Yes, a push.
Yeah, right here. That was a carry. Yeah.
Right now we have Jada Allen. She's been around volleyball and recreation a very long time. Even when she was in the junior program, she was playing with the seniors. Look like we have miscommunication. Both of them wanted to spike that ball.
And our next
server. They both called it. They both wanted it. One got to let one go.
And our next server is number 18, Alexander Ortiz Vargas. And he serves the ball into the net. And that's a side out. Another point for Corey. So the score right now, Corey's leading 17, zone 9.
Up to serve right now, we have Angel McAllister from St. Martin de Porres.
Good serve.
All right, we had zone was in the net, so we have a point for zone. Remember, the only thing that can touch the net in volleyball is the hair. It has no control.
So you can see Muhammad Roby touches the net after he back sets. And he touches the net again. Okay, and we have a timeout. The score right now is Corey 19, zone 9. Now, Ashley, I know we do have some wonderful programs for children to participate. And we actually have the lifeguard program, which is a certified training through the Red Cross. I mean, your children can become certified. They can become a lifeguard today. They must be at least 15 years old, swim 500 yards nonstop, retrieve a 10-pound weight from the bottom of a pool, pass a written test, and guess what? They can become certified and be a lifeguard. Only thing you need to do for additional information is just call 664-3018, 664-3018. Another great serve. Lack of communication there. That's a point, and this is actually a game point. You only need 21. Oh, 25, right, this is the senior, thank you. Score right now is Corey 20, zone 9. Nice recovery.
Pass.
And that ball is out. So we have another point, Corey 21, zone 9.
Corey is looking real focused, playing great as a team, communicating. That ball is out as well. We have 10 to 21.
So we have, zone actually has the ball, and our server is number 4, Intisar Musa. She actually attends International Newcomers Academy, and she wants to become a lawyer or a teacher. That's outstanding. She's actually on the merit roll, perfect attendance. Just scored a point for zone, and the score right now is zone 11, Corey 21.
Zone is going to have to get these serves over if they want to.
Oh, that's a side out. Another point for Corey.
Up to serve is Carolyn McKenzie from St. Martin de Porres. Her career goal is a physical therapist.
And that ball is out. We have a side out. And our server for zone coming up is Muhammad Roby. He actually attends John Marshall. He's a 12th grader. He would like to become a mechanical engineer. He's on the honor roll, has perfect attendance. In addition to volleyball, he also loves basketball.
Here we go.
So it looks like zone is trying to make a comeback here. That was a nice set.
That spike was a little low.
Another good serve by Muhammad. Good bump. Nice set.
Nice spot.
Oh, nice. Zone is trying to make a comeback here. Score right now.
1 point at a time.
Good
one serve at a time. Let's see if they can get this one.
Ooh, nice spike.
Good dig.
Nice set. And that ball is in. And that's another point. Score right now, zone 15, Corey 22. Zone is making a run. You'll probably see the coach for Corey call a timeout if he scores another point. Oh, my goodness. Zone scored another point. Right now, the score is zone 16, Corey 22.
Zone's on fire right now.
Let's see if they set the ball up.
Nice communication.
Nice back set. And that was an illegal hit. That was a lift. And we have a timeout by Corey.
Good try. Good hustle. Once that hand is open and you go to attempt to hit the ball, the referee is going to call that every time as a lift.
So I think right now zone coach is actually Coach Samantha Blaha. Actually, Samantha was a 2008 graduate of Lincoln West. She played basketball and all rec sports at Clark. She has 2 years in recreation, 2 years coaching volleyball, baseball, rookie league, basketball. She's assisted by Alicia Connor. She's a 2015 graduate of Berea High School, and she played recreation ball at Clark Recreation. And how about the coach for Corey Lightning, Victoria Thomas? Tell me about her.
Victoria Thomas, she's a 2001 graduate from East Tech. Played volleyball, basketball, golf, and track. She did weightlifting, softball, attended Central State, played volleyball, tennis. 6 years coaching volleyball and softball. 16 years in recreation, playgrounds, and Highland Golf Course at rec centers.
And another nice serve
nice
by Muhammad Roby. And that ball is, the refs are calling the ball out, so that's the point.
Let's look at the replay.
Oh, that was close. So the score right now is Corey 23, zone 18.
Oh,
wow. That ball is out, so we have a side out. And our server for zone is number 3, Anna Sangel. She actually attends Rhodes. She's a 12th grader. Her career goal is to be a business executive. She's on the merit roll, attendance. Nice spike there. That ball is out. Boy, that was a nice spike by Jada Allen.
We have our game point, 19-24, Corey. Up to serve, we have number 1, Jessica Suber.
Nice serve. Nice bump. Oh! And that's game. So the Corey Lightning Bolts win the first game, 25-19. So
one thing Corey did as a team and how they pulled it off, they communicated. They talked with each other, they trust each other, and they got a lot of serves over. They're playing great team ball right now.
So that was really a great game. So tell me more, Ashley. I know there's some new basketball programs coming up for 2019.
So we have our House League basketball, which is starting right now. You can call any of our rec centers that's listed. Our House League basketball is from ages 4-18. We have our girls basketball. You can call 216-664-2014. We have our youth teams that practice over at Sterling on Mondays and Fridays. We're over at Zone for instructionals for ages 8-11. And then our girls basketball juniors and seniors will start in March. But our House League's starting now. So you can call 216-664-2014 for girls basketball and 216-664-3535 for our House League basketball. We also is excited for our new AAU programs. We are looking to sponsor 10 basketball teams, grade level 4-11. You can call 216-664-3535 or 664-2014. And all our programming is free.
So we're getting ready for the second game. The Corey Lightning Bolts actually won the first game. It was a very competitive game. Zone tried to make a run towards the middle of the game, but fell a little short. And again, for the Zone Raiders, they're going to have to pick it up. And the coach said the keys to the game is that you have to communicate on the floor. And they didn't do a good job communicating. And there has to be teamwork. So I expect Zone is going to play a better game for the second game.
Yeah, they had that timeout. They know what they have to do. They know what they did wrong in the first game. So they're going to try to come back out, fix those mistakes, and try to pull off this W against Corey Recreation. Corey Recreation is very focused right now.
So again, I think with Zone, as far as their key players, Istasar Musa, number 17, and Alexander Ortiz, number 18, and also Ariana Brown, they're going to have to try and rally the team to, you know, focus. Let's go ahead, get our serves in, and let's win this game. This game is important for Zone because you only have to win two out of three and you win the championship.
So Zone has a lot of fighting to do in this game if they want to pull this away from Corey Recreation Center.
So viewers, here we go. We're getting started with the second game. Again, Corey Lightning Bolts won the first game. And our first server for Corey is number 11, Stanley Martin.
Stanley Martin is a 10th grader at Bard. His career goal was a football player. He loves soccer, volleyball, and flag football.
Nice serve.
That's what we call a true ace. Nice serve by Stanley. Another nice serve. That ball is still playable. Oh, nice recovery. Oh, caught him off guard.
You got to play into the whistle. Until you hear that whistle, don't stop playing.
So we have a side out. And our first server for Zone is number 10. Ariana Brown, who attends Max Hayes. They're calling that a lift, so that's a point. But Ariana Brown, her teacher says she's just an outstanding person. Her career goal is to become a teacher and also a coach. She's on the merit roll, and she also plays basketball. Oh, nice spike. Oh!
And that ball, is out. Good hustle, nice spike in the back row position.
So we have a side out, and the ball goes to Corey. Oh, nice try. So our server is number 3, Jada Allen. Nice dunk. Nice bump. Nice set. Good spike. Oh!
That ball was out.
That ball is out. So we have another side out, and the ball goes to Zone. And our server is Alexander Ortiz. He attends Promise Academy, and he's one of the key players to watch.
Nice serve. He was a big help in the playoffs.
So Alexander also would like to become a teacher or dancer. He's on the merit roll and have a good citizenship. Nice recovery. Oh, miscommunication. So the score right now is just nice recovery there.
Yes, nice hustle.
He caught everybody off guard. Nobody communicated. So the score right now is Zone 5, Corey 2. Nice serve.
Nice dig.
Oh. So that's an illegal hit, man. Looks like Zone saying, hey, we need to win this game.
Yes.
Score right now is Zone 6, Corey 2.
Thank you.
Now, folks, you know what's happening right now. I'm going to tell you, this game is so exciting that our fans have all their cell phones out trying to take pictures of this game. That's how exciting this game is right now. So that was just a little slight delay. And that ball goes into the net. And we have a side out.
And up we have number 15, Maurice Gray. He's a senior at Invictus. His career goal is community service job to help his community. Sound like he's going to be working for recreation.
Nice serve. So again, Ashley, I think this is going to be a close game because Zone knows that this is it, that they really have to win this game to force a third game. Oh, that ball is out. We have a side out. And our next server for Zone is number 4, Intisar Musa. Her career goal is to become a lawyer or a teacher. She's on the merit roll, perfect attendance. And she scores another point for Zone. Score right now is Zone 8, Corey 4. Can Intisar continue to keep this scoring rally going? And we have a replay there. So that ball actually touched the net going over, so that's a side out.
Right now we have number 8, Carolyn McKenzie, St. Martin de Porres. Her career goal is a physical therapist. But that ball is out.
And that ball was in.
They caught it in. She even thought it went out.
So the score right now is Corey 6, Zone 8.
And Carolyn McKenzie is a key player. She is a 3-year player, will try out for college, so we'll be seeing her playing for college. And we have a substitution right now that's going on.
Right, so we actually have number 11, Francesca Leonardo is coming in for Angel Perez. Nice serve. Oh, that ball goes into the net. We have a side out.
Let's try this again. Her second serve up. Nice serve. Good pass.
Oh, goodness. That's another point. Score now is tied up. Corey 8, Zone 8. Nice serve. Oh, we have a side out.
All right, 9, Corey. I'm sorry, 9, Zone, and 8, Corey.
And our server is number 12, Muhammad Roby, who attends John Marshall. His career goal is to become a mechanical engineer. He's on the honor roll and it's perfect attendance. Nice spike. Nice recovery. Oh, good rally. Good try.
The crowd is really into this game.
And that was a nice set.
Game.
Good serve. That ball is out.
And this is number 7, Isaac Harris from Benedictine. His career goal is a zoologist.
Nice serve. Oh, that's a side out. This is really a close game actually right now. The score is tied up again. Corey 10, Zone 10. And our server is number 3, Anna Sangle, who attends Rhodes. Her career goal is to be a business executive. She's on the merit roll and has perfect attendance. Nice set. That ball. Well, Alexander, the ref is saying he broke the plane. He was over the net. So that's a side out. So
he went over the net.
He went over the net. If you can see, his hand went all the way over the net. So the ref is just trying to explain what happened. Okay, the score right now was Corey 11, zone 10. And our server is number 5.
Geneva Payne. Geneva Payne, she wants to be a lawyer or a cosmetologist.
And so we have like a side out.
We had a battle for that ball right there. That was a nice. Good blocking at the net. If he was a little closer, he would have got it to the other side.
Our server is number 11, Francesca Leonardo. And that's a side out. And Alexander just needed to just relax a little bit. Let's take a look at this play. He went straight up. Yeah, that's a carry. Once his hand broke, it's like a hold on the ball. Good recovery.
Good,
nice recovery.
Good hustle. Okay.
And we have a side out.
Zone.
And we have some substitutions. Nice recovery.
Looked
Alexander
like
stayed focused.
Angel McAllister is coming in for Geneva Payne.
And we have another substitution for zone. We have number 13, Lydia Nahibas, is coming in for number 3, Anna Sangal. And the score right now, we have a tied game, Corey 12, zone 12. Again, Corey won the first game, so if they win this game, they will be the 2018 senior co-ed volleyball champs. So it's important that zone, you know, get back into this game. And they really need Alexander Ortiz just to stay focused and relaxed, because he is one of the key players to watch. And he's a key piece to the Zone Raiders team. So they actually have 3 individuals, Alexander Ortiz, Intisar Musa, and Ariana Brown. And again, for zone, their key players are Jada Allen, number 3, number 8, Carlin McKenzie, and also number 15, Maurice Gray. So again, for zone, the coach is saying the keys to the game is that they have to communicate on the floor. They need teamwork. They had some extra practices that she really thought would pay off in a championship game. And then for Corey, the keys to the game is that the coach is saying, hey, guys, we need to encourage each other. Let's communicate, and let's play together as a team. And so far, they've done a good job, and they won the first game, and they're looking to take the second game to win the championship. So I think we're ready to play. Our server is number 10. And number 10 is Ariana Brown, who attends Max Hayes. Nice serve. Nice bump. Nice play. Good bump. Nice. Oh, and we have a side out. Good play. That was really a good dump off by Maurice Gray.
Right now we have Jada Allen.
Look at Maurice, nice little dunk.
Nice dink, because the boys cannot spike from the front row, and he knows that. Good hustle from number 11.
Nice spike.
They are playing great team ball, Corey. Look at the bump.
Nice set.
Spike, even though it hit the top, they remember it was not over. They can still play it.
Nice serve. And that ball goes out, and we have a side out. And the score right now, Corey is up 14, zone 13. And our server for zone is number 18, Alexander Ortiz. Oh, and that ball goes out and we have a side out.
Zone has to try not to get frustrated right now. They have to stay calm and play their game.
And I think the coach is just not sure if she's looking for a lineup check. So this is some, I mean, they're playing really good ball. I mean, this is a really, really tight game. Okay, and we do have a substitution. We actually have number 11. Francesca Leonardo is coming in for Angel Perez. So score right now again, Corey 15, zone 13. And our server is number 15, Maurice Gray.
Maurice Gray, this would be his last year playing. So I know he would love to take this championship home. Oh, wow.
Nice play. Score right now is Corey 16, zone 13.
What the coach is telling them, you play it off the net. You're able to play it off the net. It can bounce off the net right here. You can play that.
Okay, and our server is number 15. Let's see if Maurice.
See if he can give them another point.
In the net.
Now the key thing for zone is to get these serves over. They need every serve. Every serve counts.
And our server was number 4. Intisar Musa scores another point. And the score right now is Corey 16, zone 15. Nice serve. Oh, and that ball goes into the net. And we have a tied game again. Corey 16, zone 16.
Zone knows they need this because if they don't, that would be a championship for Corey.
And we have a side out.
So we're back at it, 16-16.
And we have another substitution. We have number 3, Anna Sango, coming in for Lydia Nahimbaz. And our server is number 8, Carlin McKenzie.
Nice hustle to bring it back over. Right now, zone is playing very careful because they know they need every point, and they get it.
Good try. And our server right now is number 12, Muhammad Roby.
That ball was in. It was a close one. That was a perfect spot.
So that's what we call an ace serve. So zone takes the lead. The score is 18, Corey 17. Another nice serve by Muhammad. Nice set. And that ball is down. That's another point.
19-17, zone.
And again, the zone Raiders. Nice recovery, nice. Nice spike. And that ball is out.
Right
now, another point for zone.
Zone is on a streak right now. I think it's about 3 or 4. They're looking to, they have to win this game to go to a third match to 15. Remember, all games is win by 2. You have
to win
by
2. Let's see if Muhammad can score another point. And again, Muhammad would like to become a mechanical engineer. Good serve. Nice volley.
Nice way to be at the net.
Nice spike. They said the ball is in. Let's take a look at the replay. Nice set. Nice spike. That's pretty close, so referee said it was out, right? They said it was out.
They called it in.
Oh, they called it in. Okay, but that was a very close call. So again, you know, viewers, we have a number of programs that kids can participate in.
Like our rowing program we have through the city at our local recreation centers. You can call any of your centers closest to you to find out about our rowing program, which you can call 664-3018. And this is a new program that we have. And indoors, summertime, we go outdoors to some of our bigger pools to teach the proper technique of rowing. But if you want your kids to participate, you can call 216-664-3018.
And our server is Muhammad Roby. Right now, zone is on a run. And that ball is in.
That ball looks in.
Score right now is 22, zone 17. Corey, you only need 25 points to win this game. So again, keys to the game for zone is that, again, communicate on the floor. Nice bump. Nice volley. Let's see if she sets it up. Oh, nice back set. Nice. Nice play. That was a really nice play by Francesca Leonardo.
That ball may have been out. If he wouldn't have touched it, that ball may have been out. Let's look at this replay.
That ball is out. So we have a side out.
So we have 23 zone and 8 for Corey, 18 to Corey. And right now we have number one, Jessica Suber, with the serve. And the point goes to Corey. Let's see if she can give them another one.
Another nice serve. So the call is that number 11, Francesca Leonardo, actually went underneath the net. Another nice serve. Nice. And they're actually calling that ball a lift. So let's look at the replay. Nice set, but they're really saying she carried the ball. Nice serve.
Right now they have to communicate. They're playing very careful. They're not playing as aggressive as they normally play, because they know they need every point.
Nice. The spike. So that ball, when it went over, it touched the net going over up above.
That was a very good volley. You can see the concentration from both teams.
So this is game point for zone. Our server is number 3, Anna Sango. Can she score the winning point? Nice spike. Nice net recovery. So that's a side out. But she actually went underneath the net. So let's take a look at the replay. Off the net, once she slid underneath, you can't see it, but her hand went underneath the net. Nice serve.
So it looks like Corey touched the net, and that will give Zone the game. 25-22.
Zone wins the game, 25-22.
They really needed to pull that off. So now we're going into our third match. This time we will play to 15. You have to win by two. So this is for all the marbles. This is for the championship.
So you can tell both teams actually really prepared for this championship match. I mean, this is very exciting. Corey won the first game. Zone said, that's okay. We're going to come back and win the second game. And now this third game is the big game. This is for the whole enchilada. Whoever wins this game can say, hey, we were the 2018 Senior Co-Ed Volleyball Champs. I'm excited, and we got to tell our fans because they're so excited. They're in the stands, pulling out their cell phones, taking pictures, flashes going where the referees had to say, wait a minute, no flashes during the game. So, folks, just hold on. This is going to be an exciting game. Ashley, what can you say?
I know both teams really want this game. I'm glad to see it go three. They've been playing hard. They're talking to each other. They're communicating. They're using those knee pads. They want the championship. They want it.
So you know what? There's a lot of programs that the city of Cleveland offer, and you know what? One of those important programs is the after school meals, and the city also have summer lunches. I mean, parents, take advantage of it. The program runs from 3 to 5 p.m. This is after-school meals, summer lunches. These programs are available. Only thing you have to do, call 216-664-2305. Again, call 216-664-2305. And that's for the after-school meal program. Well, we're going to take a quick break as both teams get together and prepare for the final game, which will crown the new champ for 2018.
Become a professional American Red Cross certified lifeguard today. You must be at least 15 years of age, be able to swim 500 yards nonstop, retrieve a 10-pound weight from the bottom of a pool, and pass a written test. Lifeguard training classes are signing up right now. For more information, call 664-3018. That's 664-3018.
We are here with our 2018-2019 Youth All-Stars. Right now we have the Clark Recreation Youth Volleyball Team. We are going to present them with their medals for the 2018-2019 season. And we are right here right now with our youth, Zelma George, All-Star Volleyball Team. We will present them with their All-Star medals. And we are here with Earl B. Turner Youth All-Stars, and we will present them with their medals. Smile. We're here with our 2018-2019 Youth Medal Presentation. We have our Glenville Recreation and Zone Recreation Youth All-Stars, and they're going to, parents and sister will present them with their medals. Okay. Put them on.
All right.
And that concludes our 2018-2019 Medal Award Ceremony. Thank you. All right, welcome back to our third match of this championship game against Corey Lightning Bolts and Michael J. Zone. They both got a win apiece, so we're looking at our third match. Then this game is going to 15.
So right now the refs are checking to make sure that the lineups are correct and the girls and guys are in the correct position. And Corey's actually gonna serve.
And right now we have Maurice Gray, number 15. He's a setter, he's a blocker. He's also one of our key players of the game.
Nice serve. Nice play off the net. And that's a point for Zone. So side out. And our server for Zone is number 10, Ariana Brown, who attends Max Hayes. She's 11th grader. Her career goal is to be a teacher, a coach. Great serve, and that's a lift. So she scores the first point for Zone.
Deep server.
So Ariana actually, let's look at this replay. That was a really hard serve that he couldn't move back fast enough. Nice, another hard serve. So score right now is Zone is 3, Corey 0.
Let's see if she can set the record of 18 serves.
Nice recovery. Nice bump. And that ball is out. Score right now is Zone 4, Corey 0. And again, the coach said, hey, the keys to the game. Oh, another hard serve. So you know what? The coach said they actually had extra practices. And she said it's going to pay off at the championship game, and you're seeing that right now.
Yes. I think we may have a timeout.
So we just have a brief discussion. We have a timeout. Score right now, Zone 5, Corey 0.
Corey's going to tell them they need to regroup. We are only going to 15. We don't have time to make mistakes. Not too many, of course, but we are going to 15, so we have to, every point counts.
Right, and the key players to watch for Zone is Instasar Musa, Alexander Ortiz, and Ariana Brown. Those are their three key players, but obviously they have three more players that play a major role with this team actually winning.
And three of our key players for Zone, I'm sorry, for Corey is Jada Allen, Carolyn, and Maurice Gray. And they're going to have to step it up and play hard, and they're going to have to communicate. Right now it's a lot of drop balls.
And our server again is number 10, Ariana Brown. Let's see if she can continue to scoring. Nice serve. And that ball is down. That's another point. Score is 6, Zone, Corey 0. And as Ashley said, hey, the first team that hits 15 and wins by more than 2 will become the champions. Nice bump. Ah, that's another point.
Right now, Corey is... They're thinking too much. They're not having fun. They're a little. They look a little stressed out there.
That ball is out. So again, when you look at the keys to Corey winning, that the coach said, "Hey, you guys got to communicate." That's another point. Uh-oh, we have a player down. Player injured. I think he actually hurt his wrist. Looked like he hurt his wrist when he fell down right there. He landed on his wrist. Great hustle, and he just landed on his wrist.
Yeah, it's the wrist. We'll get him some ice.
Yeah. And I guess at this point we should, you know, tell our viewers there's a number of wonderful programs that the city offer.
And we also have after-school meals from 3 to 5. So once the kids get out of school, do their homework, they can come on over to the Recreation Center and get an after-school meal. The number to call is 664-2570. And that's our after-school meal program.
So our player is okay. So he's okay. So we're talking about number 11, Stanley Martin, was able to get up. A little shooken. He's been playing a great game. So right now, again, this is the third and final game. The team that wins this game becomes our 2018 Senior Co-Ed Volleyball Champs. So you hate to see Stanley have to go out of the game because he's been playing so well. So we're going to get started here. So the ref just explained Stanley has to wait one full rotation before he can come back into the game. So they just want to make sure that Stanley is okay before he starts playing again. So here we go. Our server for zone is number 10, Ariana Brown. Score right now is zone 9, Corey 0. Again, this is the third and final game, and whoever scores 15 points wins the game.
Right now, zone has the advantage with 9-0. Let's see if she can keep her serve.
Another nice serve. And that's another point. Score right now is zone 10, Corey 0. Another good serve. Nice recovery. Nice set over. Okay, and we have a side out and a point.
It ricocheted up top. It kind of threw off where they thought the ball was going to go. So Corey's able to get the ball back. And one of our key players right now, number 3. Uh-oh.
Nice play. Great try. That spike goes into the net. We have a side out. Score right now.
That ball is out. Right now we have number 16, Angel McAllister from St. Martin de Porres.
And we also have substitutions coming in for Corey. We have number 11, Stanley Martin, coming in for number 7, Isaac Harris.
They taped up his wrist and gave him an ice. He says he wants to play.
Nice serve. That's a point. So the score right now is 3 Corey, zone 11.
Angel McAllister back to serve. Can she keep her serve? And it's an ace.
Nice ace.
Angel wants to be a zoologist or a choreographer. She has a merit role at St. Martin de Porres and she plays volleyball.
Ball goes into the net and we have a side out. And our next server is number 4, Intisar Musa. Really nice serve. Nice bump. Oh. Unfortunately, Carlin McKenzie tried, good effort, but she crossed the net. Score right now. She really made a great effort trying to get to the ball.
That ball is short. We're going to need a consistent server right now. She has a time to redeem herself. Carolyn McKenzie. She's from St. DeMarc.
Oh.
A little too short.
That ball goes into the net and... Well, guess who's up to serve? We have Alexander Ortiz can actually
serve. We have
serve.
A timeout for Corey. We are at 14-5 zone.
So this is really it. If Alexander can actually serve the ball in and score a point, this is game. So this is game point. Third and final game. Both teams actually won a game apiece. Zone came out hot this game by scoring the ball. We'll try and see if Corey can get back into the game. The good news is that Stanley Martin, number 11, who actually had a hand injury, was able to come back into the game. And he's a key part of this team. So let's see if they can get the ball back. So our server is Alexander. Does a jump serve, and that's an ace. What a way to
win the game.
What a way to win the game with a jump serve. That is it. The Zone. Michael Zone Raiders win the 2018 co-ed volleyball game. What an exciting game.
Very exciting. Zone wanted it a little more. They worked very hard. They played great team volleyball. Both teams played very well. And that's the end of our match for the third game. With Michael J. Zone, we'll be right back with our championship co-ed volleyball team.
Got a corner?
Welcome back with our 2018-2019 Senior Division Co-Ed Volleyball Champions. Yeah. We're here with Michael J. Zone, and I want to present to you our Senior Co-Ed Championship Trophy. Now, you guys were down 1-0 with that first game. Coach, what did you tell your team for them to come back and win it 2-1?
Shake it off, teamwork's all it's about, and just keep it going.
I want to congratulate you guys again on your 2018-2019 champions, and I'm going to go back to you, Yaz.
Thank you.
Well, there you have it. Michael Zone Raiders are the 2018 Cleveland Coed Volleyball Champs. In closing, we'd like to thank Frank G. Jackson, the mayor of Cleveland, Michael E. Cox, director of public works, Sam Gissentanner, commissioner of recreation, Kathy Allen, TV20 general manager, Harry Paterna, TV20 with the truck and engineer, Doug Phil, our director today, Patrick Lombrake, our tape operator, Eddie Malone, Dan Monoro, and Linnell King on camera, Leah Heslog, our CG tech, Ralston Douse, our technical director, and of course, we'd like to thank all the parents and supporters, the volleyball instructors. Hey, remember, keep watching TV20. We are Cleveland. Our Cleveland kids will always amaze you. Have a happy new year, everyone.